gonna get fired, Yanni.
Two Yiddens.
Two Yiddens.
Two Yiddens were sitting next to each other in a New York bar, yeah? After a while, one Jew looks at the other and says...
No, no, no. So there were two Jews sitting at the table, and neither of them were speaking, and the one Jew said, oh, hang on, I've got to go. I'll tell you later. Bye.
Do it later.
Welcome to the shtick.
Hi there. Hello, Rabbi.
Just a minute.
We're here, first of all, explain that we're at the Multicultural Harmony Festival today. It's a special one today.
Where people of all races and creeds get to poke their tongue out at each other.
Yeah, and mingle if they want, and eat together and break bread.
It's nice, I can see that's lovely food over there, nice. Yeah.
There's a few pitters over there that looked a bit verschimmelt, but otherwise they look, not too bad.
Mm. But that's our setting for the day, but really we're here because, not that this is a joke, but really the thing...
No, we want to make laughter, we want to make fun, and we want everybody to enjoy with us.
Yes.
And be funny.
So laughter.
Laughter.
This is a total shock to me. I've been doing a segment on this television show, how long? I don't know, years now.
Yes. Nearly five.
And I've been told that people are sitting at home and they are laughing at what I'm doing. And I'm disgusted. I'm a serious rabbi. I've got serious things to say. And if you are laughing when you see me, you have got it wrong. Don't laugh. If I want to be laughed at, I'll go home. My wife, she laughs at me. She makes me feel this small.
But we laugh with you. You understand? That's the difference.
Oh, she's laughing at.
That's her job. Our job is we laugh with you. You understand? Because we laugh.
You may laugh. My wife.
I laugh at you. Generally, often.
You know what? I think it's very hard being a man in the modern era. Because we don't get respect.
Try to explain that one. You don't get respect from your wife.
Well, nobody we get it.
Isn't that why Jewish husbands
die early? They're in the ground quick.
Why do they die early?
Because they want to.
Boom, boom, that's one. We got one out. We got a joke out.
Yeah,
what happened to the joke on the phone? Did you get the end of it?
I don't know. You know, kids, you try to explain a joke to them, you can't get anything.
When you try to get a joke from someone and you say to them, give me a joke, it's very hard off the cuff to just think of one. So
I can't tell jokes without this.
Well, then do
it's
it.
It's all hand movements.
Yeah.
It's all expression. It's all in that. Because otherwise, there are. And I'm not a very good joker.
It's interesting, because the center of jokes is often the clash of cultures. And here we have today a clash of cultures. And one of our joke, which represents the difference between cultures, it is it's a rabbi and a priest sitting together on a train. And they're discussing the various injunctions of their religions. And the priest says to the rabbi, a Catholic priest, he says, Rabbi, tell me, just between us, have you ever, in all of your life, tasted ham? And the rabbi said, to tell you the truth, just between you and me, once I had a little taste. And the rabbi said to the priest, then tell me, you are a Catholic priest, have you ever enjoyed the delights of the female form? Have you ever had sex? And the Catholic priest said, when I was younger, once I did. And the rabbi said to the priest, it's better than ham. So always there's a clash, there's a hint. And here we are surrounded by different cultures, all with their own humor, all with their own story. It's beautiful to be here.
We're now going to go and see what the new mayor of Port Phillip has to say. We'll be right back after that.
Unfortunately, in more recent years, this country's treatment of asylum seekers and the introduction of an unfair citizenship test and the removal of multiculturalism even from the name of the Department of Immigration and Multiculturalism severely challenged those values. Now the current federal government has improved things, but it still operates an offshore detention centre for asylum seekers out on Christmas Island. And it still maintains that excision of places like Christmas Island from Australian territory so that for immigration purposes asylum seekers don't have access to the Australian legal system. Now this festival brings together different communities, many of whom are already developing links. There's refugees from the Horn of Africa, there's people experiencing homelessness and food insecurity. There's our own indigenous communities. And this year's Harmony Day is promoting a green message through music, song, dance, art, sport out on the Oval, food and lots of displays and stalls. So it's a terrific program waiting for you all. There's African drummers, Israeli and Bollywood dancing, the Hare Krishna Bhajan Band, the Spectrum Multicultural Choir, and Indigenous music and dance. So you can also join in Buddhist chanting and find out more about the Parliament of World Religions. So there's plenty on to keep us occupied for the afternoon. And talking of religion, later in the afternoon, I will be launching the City of Port Phillip's Multi-Faith Network first publication called City of Sharing. And I'd suggest you grab a copy from the Multi-Faith booth, which is over the other side over there, even if you're not religious, because it's an amazing collection of stories just how this community depends so heavily on its faith organisations for our humanity and sense of fairness and inclusion in the City of Port Phillip. But while we are a pretty tolerant place, we must always be on our guard. The recent anti-Semitic attacks in Balaclava demonstrate that, unfortunately, racism is far from dead and buried. And as a community, we need to condemn racism every time it raises its ugly head.
So we're back with this, the mayor of Port Phillip was dealt with respect, not like us, but we're here, we're celebrating culture and comedy. And culture, we know we're always trying to do the same thing, and I am reminded of a story. A fella was always telling Jewish jokes to all of his friends, Jewish jokes. And one friend finally said to me, he said, I'm sick and tired of you always telling Jewish jokes. So he said, all right, I won't tell any more Jewish jokes. I've got a story. There's a Japanese family, a nice family, and their young child was 13, and they said, where are we going to have the bar mitzvah? So it's very hard to get away from where you come from.
It's and a cultural crap.
It's a we are trapped
a
in
trap,
our culture.
Trap.
Absolutely, we are trapped.
And saying that, we're going to go to Candy and Simon, who are vox-popping and asking everybody here for their own jokes.
Hi, everybody, I'm Simon. This is...
I'm Candy, hi.
We're here at the Harmony Multicultural Festival in Alma Park. Today we're going to walk around and see what makes people laugh.
My dogs are really funny.
What's funny to me is, what can I say, eating too much.
We dance and we sing by ourselves. We don't need CD or DVD.
People, when they talk to each other, they just like bag each other. So, but it's in the... joking kind of way.
Yes, but me no speak English.
There's a lot of fun in like the stereotypes that we sometimes deem racist, but when you do see them happening in your own society, you sort of laugh at them. Like
when God created heaven and earth, he created Adam and Eve white, and he put them in the Garden of Eden, and and they sinned. They had the apple. That's why we have to pay for cars, houses, everything today. If you would have came down to Australia and created Adam and Eve Aboriginal, there'd be no sin. We'd eat the snake bush tucker. Everything would have been free. So that's what comedy is all about.
But the humour has kept us alive and survived.
Yeah. Now, here's another one. A Jew...
No more jokes.
Enough.
Finito,
okay.
La jokes. Okay.
Okay, well, then let's just say... After the break, we'll be back with Lana Schwartz, who's appearing at the Comedy Festival.
Yep.
And she'll be talking to our good friend Adam.
Yep.
And we'll see you after
and
that.
Rabbi, thank you so much for coming.
Yes, you were hilarious.
We love you. We respect you.